Thanks, students. So in this class we are going to discuss about sine convention for the measurement of distance. So we follow the Cartesian sine convention. So here this is a Cartesian sine convention. So here that x dash, so it's positive x-axis, negative x-axis, positive y-axis, negative y-axis. So O is the origin. Just compare with the mirror. So here that mirror m dash, so pole P is as a origin. So here this is positive x-axis, negative x-axis. So positive y-axis, negative y-axis. So we take the distance. So whatever the distance we are measuring from the pole, so the object should be placed at the left hand side of the mirror. So whatever the object, so we should place the object left hand side of the mirror. Then so the distance, so we are measuring a distance along the direction of incident light is taken as positive. So the distance measured along the direction of incident light is taken as positive. Then along the direction of against the direction, that is taken as negative. So that is opposite to the direction of incident light is taken as negative. Then height of the object, so the object should be placed on the principal axis, that is x coordinate. So here the object is placed along the principal axis. So above the principal axis means positive, then below the principal axis is negative. So if you compare with one example, you can understand more clear. So case I had discussed in the previous class. So the image formed by the concave mirror, so the object is placed beyond the center of curvature. Image is formed between the center of curvature and focus. So what is the object distance? Image distance. So object distance means, that is u, distance between the object and the mirror. So OA is a object distance. So left hand side of the mirror, that is negative x-axis, so minus. So OA is, that is object distance u, it should be minus. Then image distance, so the image is formed left hand side of the mirror. So here I dash is the image. So IP is that image distance P. So it's left hand side of the mirror, so it's negative. Then height of the object, so here object is placed above the principal axis. So above the principal axis means positive. Then image is formed below the principal axis, so the height of the image is negative. Then so what are the other cases for convex mirror? So in case of concave mirror, so u is object distance, v is image distance, f is focal length, r is radius of curvature, then h is height of object, then height of the object, height of the object, then height of the image. So image is real and virtual. So first, in case of concave mirror, u is always negative because object should be placed left hand side of the mirror. So u is negative. Then image, so image is, in case here we get real and inverted image. In the last case we get virtual image. So that means the object is placed in front of the mirror, so between the pole and the principal focus. So image is formed behind the mirror. Just check with that. So here that is on positive x, so here we'll get a virtual image. So it's the distance is, that is along the direction of light, so the distance is positive. So from the mirror, that v is positive. Then focal length of concave mirror is negative. So if f is negative means r is also negative. Then that r is equal to 2f. So center of curvature and r same. So center of curvature means if you make it as a circle, the center is center of curvature. So that radius is a radius of curvature. So from the pole to center, that is r. So that is here, this is f, so this is 2f. So 2f equal to that radius of curvature. So focal length is negative means r is also negative. Then height of the object, so height of the object is always positive because object is placed above the principal axis. So principal axis is this one. So a ray passes through the center of focus, then focal point, so that is the midpoint of the mirror. Then height of the image, so height of the image is real then virtual. So for first four cases you will get the image is at the left hand side of the mirror. So if the object is bring close to the mirror, so it is at infinity, beyond the center of curvature, on the center of curvature, then between the center of curvature and focus, on the center of focus, then we are bringing somewhat close to the mirror. So for first four cases, image is formed below the principal axis, so it's negative. So height of the image is negative for the image is real. If it is virtual means, so the image is formed behind the mirror, so it's positive, so it is along the direction of light. Then in case of convex mirror, as usual U is always negative because object should be placed left hand side of the mirror. Then image distance, so no real image is formed. Then virtual image, so virtual image means behind the mirror it should be positive. Then focal length positive, the radius of curvature is also positive. Then height of the object always positive. So U is always negative, then height of the object should be negative because object should be placed left hand side of the mirror, both concave and convex. Then height of the object should be positive because object should be placed above the principal axis. Then the focal length for concave mirror is negative, convex mirror is positive. Then the image, so no real image is formed, only virtual image is formed. So virtual image means behind the mirror, so it's along the direction of light, so it should be positive. So in this class we have discussed, so what are the sign conventions followed for the measurement of distance in the ray diagram. So using these principles, so you need to follow that Cartesian sign convention. So positive x-axis, negative x-axis, then above plus y, minus y. So consider as a, here the mirror is there, mm dash. So the pole P is the origin. So left hand side of the mirror is negative, right hand side of the mirror positive, above the mirror positive, below the mirror negative. So okay, student.